Cyrus Fees, MMA Inside the Cage. We're here at XFC 20. We just wrapped up a huge show here in Knoxville, and I'm standing next to former WEC champion and current bantamweight in the UFC, Mr. Urijah Faber, the California kid. How was your night tonight, man? You were doing the commentary, and you were also getting into the cage doing some interviews. I know you're probably not used to doing that, so how was that experience?
It was good. You know, I feel really comfortable talking to these guys. I mean, this stuff excites me. A bunch of talented up-and-comers and some great fights tonight, so I had a good time with it.
Now, the XFC had another great night of fights. We saw a lot of big fights in this one. Scott Hot Sauce Holzman, man, I'm continually amazed every time I see this kid fight. It's like, what do you hit him with? You know, what's his weakness? He looked untouchable in that fight. Looked great.
Yeah, I think, you know, what you have there is a tremendous athlete who understands about hard work and loves the fight, you know. Yeah. So the mental game is the most important, and he definitely had it.
The females also put on a great show. Sophia Baggerdye, man, she brings it, man. She had the stand-up. She really took it to the ground, finished it off. What did you think of her performance tonight?
I was impressed. You know, you can tell she's done her homework. I think, you know, her opponent was a tough, scrappy girl, but you could tell that Sophia was the more seasoned veteran.
Well, you saw what Eric Reynolds did. He survived, you know. He had a good fight, but he ended up winning, getting the finish on that. What did you think of his performance as, you know, the XFC lightweight champion? That's a big title. What did you think of his performance tonight?
He did great. He was in a war, and he said, I'm looking for a war. He likes fights like that. He got what he asked for. You know, Lorenzo came and brought everything to him, and it was a back-and-forth battle, and he weathered a storm, and it's a great victory.
He's all set to face Nick Newell. What do you think of that fight? You've probably seen some of the footage of Nick Newell, and what he's accomplished is pretty amazing, right? What do you think of that fight coming up here in December?
I think it'll be a great fight. And I met Newell a long time ago. He came to one of my seminars, and I was really impressed with him. What an upstanding individual and a talented athlete. So I'm expecting another knockdown drag-out. I would probably give an advantage to Noel, though.
Now, you were, and talking about your career, you said you would step forward on the 153 card where they had so many injuries. Is that something you could have done? You said you're kind of nursing a rib right now. Do you think you could have come out there and had a fight there in Brazil?
I feel like I could, but I've got like a high pain tolerance. So I went to go get cleared, and they said that my rib is still displaced and all the way healed. So I probably wouldn't have been able to get cleared in retrospect. But I feel good. I've been grappling for almost 2.5 weeks. I never get out of shape. And I was walking around about 157, 158 lean. Yeah. So I could do that. I fought at 145 for a long time. I'm competitive with anybody.
Yeah. Now, we saw the fight with Barão. Obviously, didn't go your way. The title has eluded you in the UFC. You know, where are you at in your career? I know we've seen the fights, you know, with Dominic and everything, and I know you'd like to get back in the cage with him. Is that something you want really bad? Is that like a fire inside of you to get that title again? Or, I mean, you've had a title before. You've had the featherweight title in probably one of the most entertaining, you know, divisions in the WEC. Where are you at in your career? Like, how do you feel about getting a title shot? Is that really, really important to you?
It is important to me. I mean, that's why I do this sport. I've got probably, you know, 3 years of really solid top-level competition that I want to put out there. Whatever I have to do, I want to face top contenders only. I mean, that's the name of my game. I've been in this sport for 9 years. My third fight was a title fight in a small organization way back in the day, and that's what I do. I fight the best, you know, and that's what I want to do.
What did you think of your teammate, Joseph Benavidez, his fight with Demetrius Johnson? Obviously didn't get the win, but had a hard-fought fight. And what do you think about the boos that came down? I think that's the main question. There was a lot of boos in that fight from the crowd, which is kind of surprising. What did you think of that?
You know, an educated crowd, I guess. It was a great fight, in my opinion. I feel like I haven't had a chance to talk to Joseph about it yet, but I think the big difference there was Joseph was really pushing the pace at the beginning and throwing everything after, you know, Mighty Mouse, and he missed a lot, and I think that fatigued him a bit.
Yeah.
You know, Joseph is a guy that had a great training camp. No one knows, this is the first time I've said anything about this also.
Yeah.
He was injured. He lost like a lot of power in his left side for the last 3 weeks for his training camp. But his mental game and his preparation coming up to that was awesome. He had no excuses going in there. I think it was just too many missed punches, you know, and we'll work on that, and he'll be back stronger and get that belt.
Now, something that has been talked about a lot is this whole mini feud going on with Michael Bisping. Obviously, he had a great showing. He got the win, but yeah, he had all kinds of nicknames for you, all kinds of stuff about your whole camp. What do you feel about that? Is it all in good fun, or you legitimately do not like the guy?
No, it's all in good fun. I actually spent some time with him in Afghanistan, and the true thing about Bisping, he loves to joke around, but he cannot take a joke, you know. So I was just giving him some crap about that. I remember, you know, one of the military ladies came up and said something about like a foot, you know, this thing was about a foot long, and I said, well, Bisping said this was about 6 inches, and he friggin' lost it. His face got all red, and he was spitting around for a comeback, and, you know, we roused each other a little bit after that, but you know, the bottom line is, I've got respect for Bisping. I think he's a cool enough guy, but I'd get in there and scrap with him.
Well, that's what I was about to say. You know, back in the day, the old school UFCs, I mean, it was a lot of mismatches like that. The weight really didn't matter. If you got in there, in the cage, in the octagon with Michael Bisping, how would that go?
I think it'd go well. I think I'd have an advantage on the ground. I wouldn't want to take a clean punch from the guy because he's so much bigger, but, you know, for those who know martial arts, getting hit on the button is the scary thing, and I think he'd have trouble hitting me. Although I have a great big chin here, I think he might have trouble getting to it. So it'd be an interesting fight. I would do it.
Yeah.
Let's do it, Bisping. Let's do it on the internet. We can do like some sparring. We'll charge people and have a exhibition bout.
I think I'd pay the money for that pay-per-view. Final question. Now, you're a California guy. Another organization that came out of California was Strikeforce. They just had to cancel their card with Gilbert Melendez on it and Pat Healy. A lot of people wanted to see that fight. Injury, that happened. That's the second fight under the Zuffa banner that's been canceled. Do you feel like Zuffa's kind of mismanaged Strikeforce a little bit? Because it was a strong company. Do you feel like they could have did something to kind of help it survive a little bit more and do more with it?
I think the bottom line is, Showtime has the ability to keep them as long as they want it to finish out this contract, and I don't think Zuffa really has their heart behind it.
Yeah.
You know, so they're kind of, you know, letting it peter out, and I doubt that Showtime's going to want to continue paying for Showtime, but I mean for the Strikeforce, but we'll see. I mean, I don't really know the politics behind all that.
Yeah.
But I guarantee you it's a lot more in depth and intricate than you and I even know.
Yeah, I can imagine. He's the man, Urijah Faber, the California kid. This is Cyrus Fees, XFC 20 for MMA Inside the Cage.